Welcome back, everyone, to The Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and I have my good friend, Amanda.
Hello, I'm Amanda.
How's it going, Amanda?
Really good. Yeah, happy to be here. And yeah, I'm in Seattle. Happy.
Yeah, it's a beautiful, sunshiny day, as always, in Seattle, Washington.
Yeah.
And you're actually from our App Center team, correct?
Correct.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe tell everyone a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, so hi, I'm Amanda. I'm a PM on the App Center team. App Center has a range of different services. So the service that I'm working on or excited to build are basically the mobile backend as a service. We have a couple of new features, a couple of new capabilities coming out during build. So right now, we're hard at work at it.
Awesome. Yeah. And what are you going to be showing us today?
Yeah, today I'll be showing you several new features that came out in App Center distribution.
Ah, cool. Yeah, the way to get your app to your users.
Yeah.
And we've been going through each of the new features. I'm really excited for you to show it off. So why don't we just hop right into it?
Yeah, sounds good. All right, so here is the App Center portal. This would be a very familiar site for everyone. In this case, I'm in my organization, RipEye Studios, and I'm going to demo an app called Smash Up iOS. So if I click on my app and I go to distribute, I'll see a whole range of my distribution groups. This is a very familiar site. So under the distribute feature, under the distribute beacon, you can distribute to distribution groups, you can distribute to specific testers, and you can even distribute directly to the stores by connecting to the store, distribution to the Apple Store or iTunes, and for Android, the Android Store as well. And you can see all your releases here. It's one easy way to see all your release history.
So this is after you build it, either in App Center or maybe Azure DevOps, you publish it here so then all your users can get it and install it, basically.
Yeah,
got
that's
it.
Perfect, exactly. And under distribute groups, today I'll be showing three new features that recently was launched. So if I click on groups, I think right now the internet's a bit slow. Oh, I got it. So now we're on the distribute service here. What I'm going to show you is that now you can distribute to multiple testers and distribution groups, and you can have a silent release to them. So you don't email them, you don't notify them via email.
Oh, cool. So before you could only do one group or one type of user.
Yeah.
Basically.
Actually, before you couldn't even distribute to individual testers. You had to first create a distribution group, add the testers to the group, and then distribute to the distribution group. That included three steps. Now we reduce the workflow to just one single step.
Oh, very cool. Let's check it out.
Let's check it out. All right. So here, I'm going to schedule a new release. And I already have my build downloaded. Sorry. I'm going to upload my IP file.
So you're manually uploading it here, but you could do it from a build, basically, too.
Yeah. You could also choose build from branch, and then if you already have a build connected, you can choose whichever branch that you want to build from and then distribute to your users.
Got it.
So right now I'm doing it manually by uploading the IPA file, uploading the build, and then click next. You can schedule release notes, so v1.0.0, for example, and then click next. And here, immediately it tells you what distribution groups that you can distribute to. In this case, I want to distribute to my group. It's a group that I created here. And also, you can distribute to multiple testers, individual testers.
Ah, so here. You have a group and you, because you're not even in this group. It's hey,
exactly.
I want to give this to Amanda to test.
Yeah, nice. And in the past, you would actually have to add Amanda to this group. But now you can distribute directly to them.
Very cool.
And then after that, when you set it up, you can set up the devices. To manage the devices, you can go to each individual distribution group and so on. So in this case, we'll be skipping this step and click review. And here, it's another new feature. In the past, whenever we distributed a release, if the user had their email notification turned on, they'll be notified immediately. Now, we actually have this thing called Do Not Notify Testers. Release will still be available to install. So if you check this, it means that users will not receive an email. And if they go to their install portal, this installation or this release will immediately show up.
Oh, very nice. Yeah, so before, it's like I have to get email, and get constantly notified.
Yeah.
Where I already have the distribute SDK installed, so let that handle it for me.
Exactly.
Very nice. Yeah.
So here, you can distribute. You can also click this, tick this checkbox. Basically, it requires distribute to testers to update to the release. If you click this, it's mandatory. You make sure that if they're on a previous version, they will have to be updated to the latest release. If not, if you don't check this, it's the same. They can download this release.
Oh, cool.
So here, if I click distribute, and so there, after I click distribute, you can see this was the previous release that I did, my group and to the individual testers. It immediately shows you the destination, and here is the latest release, and you can click here and look at all the details of the release.
Very nice. So like a lot more control, it seems, over the release and just easily getting it out there.
Yeah, and I think the biggest value is that it takes the users less step to distribute to their users.
Nice.
In the past, you have to click on a lot of things.
Cool.
So I just showed you the first new feature that we had, and now I'm going to move on to the next feature that I'm really excited to present, which is auto-provisioning. So here, now I just did a new release. If I go to my groups, I'm going to show you how to set up auto-provisioning. Here I've already set up a group called My Group with my teammates. This is Villa's face and a couple of other people. What you do to set up auto-provisioning is basically click on this gear or this wrench button here. And if it's off, which is, it should be off, you click it on, and then you immediately add your Apple developer account. So in this case, my teammate Villers has already added his Apple developer account. You can choose to add a new account if you like, or choose the existing one. Similarly, for distribution certificate, upload your distribution certificate or add a new certificate. Mm. Once it's done, I click on done here, and you can see, because the existing testers are Villers from all his accounts, and all his devices are already provisioned. So if I were to add a new tester like myself, let's see what happened to my devices. So I'm gonna add myself as a tester. In this case, since I've already had my account, I already had an app and tested different apps on App Center, I've already registered two of my devices on App Center. However, you can see here that the status is currently unprovisioned.
Got it. So really, he had already had all of his devices registered, provision of the profile.
Mm-hmm.
But you're a brand new tester, right?
Yeah.
So your devices are registered with App Center,
yes,
but not just provisioning profile. So I'm imagining now I have to go off, ask you for your UUIDs. I got to go back to the Apple developer portal. I have to register those devices. I have to download a new cert.
Yeah.
Then I need to re-upload
Sign
it to
in,
App Center, maybe do a new build.
Yeah.
But that's what I used to have to do.
Yeah.
But not anymore, basically, right?
So basically, we have tried to consolidate the amount of steps. Previously, it was going to different portals, like 10 different steps, six different steps. But now, we allow you to do everything in the App Center portal.
Oh, cool.
So here, you can do it two ways. Either do it manually by registering devices. And in App Center, we care a lot about giving the user like a good experience. So here, we have a banner that tells you that there are two unprovisioned devices. And this is the next call to action. Click on this button to register your device.
Hmm.
So here, I would click Register Devices. And by clicking the account in which I want to, like the Apple developer account, and clicking on iPhone, two iPhones, and then resign my app, and then choosing the distribution certificate. You can also add a new certificate if you like. And then by clicking register, what this does is that it registers the two devices by Amanda, iPhone 8 Plus that we show here, into Villers Apple's developer account.
Oh, very cool.
So this is a very quick way instead of going to the Apple developer's portal. So this is the manual, you can register your device manually. Another way is to do it automatically, which is just now I've already showed you clicking on this gear button, I click on. So whenever I do a new release here, if I click this, I go through the whole flow again, and I upload a new release, automatically that these devices, they will be provisioned and ready to download the new release without the users having to do anything.
Very cool. So you can either do it manually, so you're in control, or do a new release, and boom, magically. So that's kind of cool, because as you're kicking off builds, getting new users, and it'll automatically handle it for you.
Yeah, exactly.
Very cool.
And what is really useful is that App Center is API first, so whatever you can do in the portal can also be done using our APIs.
Oh,
so it's
nice.
Very simple with all, like, with calling a few App Center or a couple of App Center APIs, you'll be able to run this workflow.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, Amanda, thank you so much for showing off these new Distribute services and features, which I absolutely love. It's one of my favorite parts of App Center. Well, they're all my favorite parts, just to be honest with you. So yeah, thank you so much for coming on and showing this off.
Thank you.
Yeah. Cool. Thanks everyone for tuning in. And don't forget to subscribe to get notifications of the latest and greatest Xamarin show right in your inbox. If you're over on YouTube, don't forget to hit subscribe and ding that bell. So, of course, you get notified for every single new episode as part of the notification squad. Thanks for watching, and this has been yet another Xamarin Show. Hey, James here. Just wanted to check in and thank you for watching this video. Now, do all the things that you know you want to do, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell to become part of the notification squad. While you're here, check out all these awesome videos that I've already recorded. Click on that thing. Click it. Watch it. Do it.